And we're back. Thank you, sponsors. As always, I'm sure that you loved sponsoring that segment that we just finished.
Oh, yeah. Those are the best sponsored segments. Devil Barrel Whiskey or whatever the fuck sponsor we just played is really a fan of tiny glasses on
picks. Well, let's get right into the news.
Let's.
There's so much of it to news talk me. About.
Just news all over me, Josh.
Ooh.
Oh, I said it. It doesn't matter. I'm sorry. Anyway, continue.
Can we stop?
We can. That was the last one, I'm pretty sure.
So, footage of a leaked Halo Megablocks game came out within the last couple weeks. I remember hearing about this like way back in the PS3, Xbox 360 days. There's a pretty good sizable amount of footage out there. But it looks like it would have been like really cool. 343 has actually since come out and said, with the amount of popularity that that video has garnered, that they actually may revive it here in the future, which is cool.
That would be okay.
Yeah,
I thought it looked really neat.
Yeah, and I like how it felt like it was trying to be kind of a legitimate third person game, not like a lot of the Lego attempts. So the controls seemed like it was better suited for that particular genre.
Yeah, the Lego games are fun a lot of the times, but or at least most of the time, but they are a very, very like unique like control scheme and setup, and they are very, very, very like carbon copy of one another. Like they always add something, but even like this most recent like Lego Force Awakens tried to add like a cover based like shooting mechanic. I mean, and it's
really
serviceable, but it's not, I mean, it's not good. You're not like, oh shit, like this is a badass third person shooter. Like, it's just kind of a thing you have to do before you can go like knock some other shit down and make Lego bricks out of it,
right?
Which is the kind of fun thing to do in those games. But yeah, this definitely looked a little more, it almost looked like, it reminded me of like Banjo-Kazooie,
yeah,
but with Halo like characters
and shooting.
Well, obviously.
Oh, the best thing was when he threw up that bubble shield and it was like the legit Lego or Mega Block Lego, or, god damn it, Mega Block shield from the Halo sets.
Yeah, with like the four circles on it for you to like stack things on and everything. It was really cool. Like the building turrets out of the Mega Blocks, things like that.
Or Tourette's.
Yeah, one or the other. You could build Tourette's if you want. either way,
everybody
like
loves Tourette's.
It would have been cool. Apparently, come to find out that like the reason that Halo is with Mega Blocks and not with Lego is that they don't do guns in Halo or in Lego. Apparently, even though they've made the exception for Star Wars, I guess it's because they're like laser guns. They like won't take any property that would require them to use guns.
Mega Blocks will.
Mega Blocks.
They've
care.
Got Walking Dead. They've got Call of Duty.
Yep. Destiny.
Mm-hmm.
There's Mega Blocks Destiny.
Yeah, you can come get them.
No thanks.
At my store.
It's okay.
There, buy one, get one half off.
No thanks.
For the love of everything holy, please come buy some.
No.
They're cool looking.
Yeah, no one is ever going to buy them.
I almost bought one.
Eventually,
for my
I'll
son
probably
for
just
Christmas.
Get to, like, just take them all home.
Wow.
And then.
I mean, you could do it now if you wanted to.
No one would notice, that's for damn sure.
I mean, you didn't notice when I took the rack of gummy bears earlier this week.
I mean,
everybody else does.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, people steal candy from those places because it's easy.
That's
especially
fair.
Employees.
Oh, okay.
Hey, I didn't bring enough money to have food today.
Let me get some of them gummy worms.
Gummy worms. Thank you, Haribo.
That was an amazing reenactment.
Yeah.
That's how they eat.
For the love of God. moving on here. So, Scalebound is no longer a thing.
I was kind of upset about this news. I don't know if I was going to get it like right offhand. It's going to be one of those like, I guess, Watch Dogs-esque kind of games for me. Like something I'd probably want to play but not buy for full price right when it came out. But it was an exclusive title for my favorite console, so I was excited about that.
Yeah,
it looked pretty.
I definitely wasn't like, I wouldn't call myself looking forward to it just because it didn't really look like my kind of game, but...
anything?
No, these days, no. Mysterium.
Mysterium, right. A board game in digital form.
Correct.
You fuck.
That's kind of where I'm at. What the fuck?
Turns out Mysterium sounds a lot like Hey Siri.
Hold on. Let's test it out. Mysterium.
Nope.
You do it.
Mysterium. Nope.
Mysterio, what you guys doing today?
No, that worked. Anyway.
Hey, Cortana.
What if my phone was just like, fuck you, bro?
Do not make me laugh.
Fuck, I don't even remember what you're talking about now.
Mysterium.
Scalebound, yeah. No, I agree with Chuck in that. Like, it's a bummer that it's an Xbox exclusive that won't see the light of day. But, you know, also, Xbox has a lot of exclusive titles, both out and coming out.
So much still on the coming out front right now. Like, not announced.
Without E3 even, like, you know, on the horizon, there's still two major releases scheduled for this year.
There's Halo and there's Crackdown.
Yeah.
Which Crackdown, you know, is part of
Sea of Thieves.
And Sea of Thieves, you're right.
Is that coming out this year?
Yep.
Supposed to.
Okay.
So that's three. Plus E3, I guarantee you there'll be at least one or two more.
I'm sure there will. I was
Sunset
really...
Overdrive 2!
Oh, God, please let that happen.
It's Insomniac, I'm telling you. That game's going to go multi-platform if it ever gets made again. Which would be cool shit still, because, I mean, people like that game, so...
Rise, Son of Rome 2!
No one wants it.
I mean, I'd play it.
God damn it.
The evolution
no one
wanted
Mac 2 either, but that shit's happening.
Yeah, well, you complain about
the
that.
The evolution of Rise.
You're going to play that
been,
too.
The evolution of Rise is called For Honor, and that would have been just as good.
That's fair.
For Honor is way more deep into combat than Rise is.
Right. A game that
like
came out almost 5 years ago, Josh.
Significantly more deep. Either way, this is
That's
one
what
of those
happens
games.
In 5 years of development cycle time.
No. Okay. This is one of those games that I was actually really stoked for when it was first announced. It's Platinum Games. It was Kamiya, who is like their main developer, who makes he's like the Bayonetta guy. That was supposedly like they had sold this as the thing that Platinum does best, which is character action, combined with the thing that Microsoft does best, which I was assuming is some sort of like cloud-based server, you know, interactive gameplay or multiplayer gameplay. But apparently this was just a mess. They had like failed to meet dates like left and right. Kamiya is reportedly taking time off for mental health reasons. Developers, like they've just been all over the place with this. I actually thought the gameplay looked awful the last couple times I saw it.
I thought it was fun.
Yeah, I know Evan was like really excited for it when he actually saw the gameplay. I thought it looked bland and boring. I was worried about that game like from the get-go, unfortunately, after I actually saw the gameplay itself. But either way, it is sad to see this, and then you combine that with what was the other game that got Phantom Dust.
Yeah,
they got canceled. It's been a while since we've seen Crackdown. Like, obviously, I hope these exclusives come out. Quantum Break came out this year, which was a game that's incredibly forgettable.
I mean, I disagree with that completely. But really? And basically, everyone that's on this podcast, but you probably disagrees with that. But I mean, it wasn't just Quantum Break. I mean, we saw ReCore. Now, ReCore is a slightly forgettable game, but it is an exclusive that they advertised. That
I mean, don't forget all the indie download games, too. I mean,
yeah.
There's a few of them coming out this year, including Cuphead and Below, hopefully Below.
Inside was Xbox
Inside.
Exclusive.
Yep. No, it wasn't.
Yeah, it was.
It's out on PlayStation.
It is now. It launched
for
as
like
an exclusive.
2 weeks.
It was not 2 weeks. It was at least several months.
It was very, very quick. Like, people talked about the quick turnaround time of that. Either way, I'm not, like, shitting on Xbox right now. I'm just saying, like, it is sad to see some of these games getting canceled in just in general. So, it's kind of out of nowhere that this happened, too. Like, people were talking about that possibly being a Scorpio launch game along with Crackdown in order to actually, like, just kind of be, like, one of those, like, showcase games. Like, really taking advantage of the new hardware, but...
Yeah, and I mean...
That's something called Halo 6.
Yeah, there's...
it's not a Scorpio launch game.
It probably isn't, but I mean, they'll probably show some footage, I guarantee you, this year at E3 of Halo 6 running on a Scorpio. Either way, I mean, I think Xbox is going to have no, you know, shortage of exclusives at this point. If you take away the insane number of, like, random super niche JRPGs that are on the PS4, as far as like AAA, like kind of widely received games, I think Xbox still has a slight advantage over.
I think it's a significant PS4. Advantage until this year. This year, Sony is guns blazing as long as they all come out.
You're talking about actually 2017?
Yes.
Yeah, they got what, Horizon?
Uh-huh.
What else?
Well, games that are in the pipeline right now,
Days Gone, if it comes
out this year. Exclusives. Not necessarily this year, but just exclusives that we actually know about right now. There's God of War, there's Days Gone, there's Detroit Become Human, Horizon Zero Dawn, The Last of Us Part 2, Death Stranding.
Yeah, that's a solid fucking lineup of games.
No, yeah, it's been, and like, look, Xbox has had some great games as well. If the controller would ever fucking work for me, I would probably enjoy playing some of them.
That's a you problem.
It really is. That thing hates me, and my brother apparently too. We couldn't get a game of Gears going to save our lives the other night. Like, it was 3 hours of trying and just talking on Xbox or on our phones while Xbox Live failed on me repeatedly, and my controller kept disconnecting. We would get like 10 seconds into the story. I think I got to a point in that first level where I was using the Hammer of Dawn to kill that spider locust or whatever.
The corpser.
And then the game just crapped out completely on me. And we tried to play some multiplayer after that. It was just a shit show.
Gears of War 4 this year was kind of a big thing.
Forza Horizon.
Like, one of my five most anticipated games of, well, five, that's probably not true. One of my 10 most anticipated games this year is an exclusive for Microsoft in Sea of Thieves. I think it looks awesome. So it's sad to see this happen along with Phantom Dust. Did you guys read that? I think it was Kotaku article about the way that Phantom Dust was handled. Like, I think Giant Bomb talked about it this week. It was fucking crazy. Like, they didn't know that they were going to have an E3 trailer when they showed it. Like, Microsoft made that trailer for them. And apparently they just told the developers, like, look out, you guys should probably watch E3. There's something cool that's there for you. They were committed to in some interview by having this like huge sprawling JRPG story that they had never planned on. And then the game itself got shut down when they asked for more money. Like, it is...
When was that officially...
Shut down?
Mm-hmm.
Last year, I think, or like
because
early 2016?
The last thing I've got is it's back.
Is it actually back?
June 2016. It's a Polygon article. Arrives this year.
We'll see. I mean, I had not heard that story, and people are, like, podcasts that
I'm
hearing.
Come on, news guys.
Are, like, still all talking about it like it is canceled, so I don't know exactly what's going on with that. But either way, it's sad to see, like, any exclusive go away, because it's definitely... Oh, Spider-Man, by the way, for PlayStation as well.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I mean, they have a strong lineup. You're right.
And Knack 2 and Gran Turismo Sport.
Gran Turismo. God.
Either way.
They had a genre by the balls, and they just
it took them
slipped
too long.
It in its Gandhi and just let it ride.
I hate you.
Go forth, Josh.
I hate you so much. The last bit of news that we're going to talk about is the Nintendo Switch.
Hey!
Nintendo had their kind of real large-scale unveiling this past week, including an event from Japan, which I'm sure we're going to talk in depth about, as well as the Treehouse Live event the next day. And
we had a poll about that. The second most responded to that poll was, it was Japanese as fuck.
Oh, it was. It very much was.
It got 33% of the vote.
Yeah, it very, very much was. We didn't do a poll this week.
We didn't.
We can
I blame you.
One. That's fair. It totally is my fault. Either way, so we have a lot more details on the Switch. The system officially comes out on March the 3rd for $299.99. Which is higher than I wanted, but still in the sweet spot of affordable for sure. Not the worst thing. It could have been $400 and would have seemed
way
overpriced.
Depends on how many accessories you put with that.
Yes. Accessory pricing, which is definitely over the top. I'm upset about the things I've got to buy for it. But not as... like, there are a lot of accessories, but not as many, like, necessary ones as originally anticipated, for sure. In terms of the actual system, I think it looks great. They showed off a lot of awesome hardware in terms of... I think the technology within that Joy-Con is really, really cool. I know that people hate the name of the Joy-Cons. The size is, I mean, definitely Gandhi-sized.
There you go. Lean right into it, Josh.
Hey, yep.
However, the 3D rumble technology that they showed off, the like IR sensor on the front, I think there's a lot of really cool things that they could possibly do with that. I am yet to be sold on it like being used for a game specifically, but I think like let's start with the hardware itself. Like with what they did show, we'll get to the conference itself later. What did you guys think?
It was enough to intrigue me to pre-order the first Nintendo system I've ever pre-ordered.
Yeah. I was actually really surprised to hear that you were going to pre-order it.
I got kids, and some of the games, first-party games, look cool.
The portability of it, I think, is, I mean...
Yes.
It's just such a big selling point for me.
I think it'll be cool if they do come out with that headrest pole thing.
Oh, for cars?
Yeah. Stick the kids in the back, and you've already got two controllers. They can play Mario Kart. You can turn on your Wi-Fi hotspot, and they can watch Netflix right there. We'll see about the functionality of it. It was enough to get me at least intrigued enough to put money on it so I can hold one for me. Because I know it's Nintendo. They're not going to have a whole lot at launch.
Yeah, they were talking about 2 million, I think, in the first initial shipment. And I know there were stories that GameStop has already sold out of their allotment completely.
They have.
A lot of online retailers, I think, have as well. Target, Walmart, all of those places are pretty much sold out. I want to say Amazon is as well. I think that like all Switches are currently accounted for. I would not be surprised in terms of like them being pre-ordered in general. Trey, what do you think of the hardware in general?
So I'm kind of with Chuck in that. I also pre-ordered one.
Oh shit! You were originally talking about nine.
Yeah, and I kind of kept going back and forth, and then just kind of the hype of everything that morning. I decided to say fuck it and go ahead and at least put the 50 down to.
Yeah. It's worth it just in case, right?
Yeah, exactly. I'm still not, because I'm still back and forth on whether or not I'm going to pick it up. Right now, it seems like a
Amazon is currently unavailable.
Yeah.
Sorry.
No, you're good. Right now, it seems like a $300 kind of novelty device. I mean, there's not exactly, especially with me not necessarily being a Zelda fan. Not that I wouldn't try the new Zelda game, but I'm just not nearly as diehard a fan as some of you guys are. So with that being the case, and there not being like a really strong launch game, it's like a thing. Like I think 1-2 Switch would be fun to play with like Lane every now and then again. And like Chuck, I totally agree with the whole car thing. Like right now, Lane takes an iPod or an iPad or whatever. Mm-hmm. It'd be cool if he could just grab the Switch if he's playing something. There are often times where we have to like fight if he gets up early in the morning and like plays a game for a little bit, and then I have to like, we go back and forth about him turning it off so we can leave for school or whatever.
Right.
It would be nice to just be like, all right, cool. Like, just grab the thing and let's go. Like, you can play it in the car. We have a 30-minute drive to school. Yeah. So stuff like that I think is neat. But, like, that's really it. Like, I'm not sold on it as any kind of legitimate gaming platform. I'm not totally sold despite the initial hype. I'm not, like, super sold on whether or not it's going to be any kind of long-term success for Nintendo. I just, like, stress pretty hard that in terms of software, it's not going to have great support. It's going to be another thing that you buy as your second or third console to play Nintendo exclusives because you like Nintendo, and that's it.
Well, Josh, give your feelings on the hardware, and then we can talk about software.
Yeah, software is definitely what we'll talk about here in a second. But in terms of the hardware, like I said, I mean, I really do enjoy what they have shown in terms of the portability aspect, the idea that I can keep going back and like just get home, drop that thing in the dock, start playing like Zelda on my my TV, and then just pick it up. And when I go to work, like I've got that there for my hour-long lunch break that I really never know what to do with. The idea that they are selling, which is incredibly smart compared to what they did with their last console, individual docks, because they had talked about selling individual Wii U gamepads originally and then dropped that idea, said it was coming in the future, and then never did anything with it again. Being able to buy just another dock, while it is expensive, it's a third of the console's price, still being able to have that in multiple TVs without having to buy multiple consoles and making it super easy to just port back and forth, I think is really, really cool. There's a ton of smart ideas in what they are doing with the hardware. And for the most part, pricing I don't think is super bad. They definitely have like the nice advantage of the cost up front. But when you start looking into the additional features and things to make it a more kind of hardcore device in a way, it does become harder to like kind of swallow the pricing on that. $10 more for that particular Pro controller than any Xbox or PlayStation controller up front costs is a little bit frustrating for sure.
The cost of the accessories is rough.
The only thing that I think is egregious is those Joy-Cons. $50 per Joy-Con or $80 for two is really
insanity.
Hard to swallow. Yeah, that is a difficult price to eat.
I think the Pro controllers...
Apparently I'm hungry and thirsty.
I think the Pro controllers are more egregious only because there's a clear point of reference. Like
preset example. I mean, there were with Wii U or Wii remotes, though, as well. Like, those things were only $30.
No, those things were $50.
$50?
Were they really?
Yes.
Yeah.
I bought four of them. Really?
Yeah. Yeah, they were $49.99.
I made a mistake.
They are now $39.99 for new ones. But,
shit. Okay, well, then that's actually right in line, and I feel like there's more in here.
There's probably more tech in there. They're a little bit... it's amazing how the fact, just because they are a very like small device, it makes you kind of not feel like it's worth...
we also haven't price of that $50. Got it in our hands either. It might feel like a really solid, manufactured piece of...
Yeah, but the Pro Controller has a very clear analog that both other system manufacturers have set a very clear price for, and now, like, all of a sudden, Nintendo just went, fuck you guys.
Yep.
Our, like,
you're going to give us money.
Tiny system that you really probably don't need a Pro Controller for a lot of things, because let's face it, you're going to play Mario and Zelda on this bitch. I mean, like, why would you pay $70 for a Pro Controller?
In my opinion, those are the games you need the Pro Controller for. The only thing you don't need the Pro Controller for are things like 1-2 Switch.
I don't think you need the Pro Controller for Mario Kart at all.
Maybe Mario Kart, but, like, I don't want to play that thing on it. Like, unless I'm going to play it literally portably and, like, while I am, like, on the go somewhere, even if I have that system with me and it's not connected to my TV, my plan is still to just think that, like, use that kickstand on the back of it, set it up on a table somewhere, and use my controller. Like, I will bring that Pro Controller with me every day I bring it somewhere.
It's got that little slot thing.
The grip?
Yeah.
I'd have to have it hands-on. Like, hopefully, I know that there's not that event that they're bringing to, like, six different cities or whatever that's anywhere near us.
It looks cheap. That particular part looks cheap. Now, the charging one
looks a little... It does look a little bit more sturdy. I'd have to see what it feels like, because right now, the verticality of those Joy-Cons, holding it as a controller, like, it looks like it would feel weird to me. It looks like it's, like, so much higher in terms of, like, the space in between the stick and the buttons that I don't know if I'm sold on that idea yet.
It's the tall version of the brick from the original Xbox was width.
Yeah.
And you turn it on its side and...
I get what you're saying there. But, like, the Pro Controller, it definitely looks very much like an Xbox 360 or rather an Xbox One or PlayStation controller in terms of, like, the size in general, which I think is going to feel much more comfortable.
Yeah. I agree with that.
Yeah, I mean, the hardware in the Joy-Cons themselves, I think, is super cool. That 3D rumble stuff, like, the way they were showing
it. The HD rumble, yeah, it looks pretty interesting.
Yeah, they showed, like, this is, imagine you're holding a glass. Now, here we're going to rumble, and you feel like you're shaking one piece of ice, and then two pieces, and then we're going to fill it with water, and you're going to feel that. Like, it reminded me of the initial selling point on the analog triggers for Xbox, and the way that, like, you know, you're going to feel the engine revving with each individual part of the controller when you're playing things like Forza. If that works legitimately, I think that's a super cool thing. And I don't know, aside from, like, they showed him playing, what, like, rock, paper, scissors with the IR sensor on the front, but having it be an IR sensor that actually recognizes some sort of gesture, I think it's kind of a cool, like, in-between with the Kinect in a way, only done specifically on the controller itself. I don't know what specifically they do with that, but I think it's definitely opening up for some cooler ideas other than just your basic, motion controls, which I am, for the most part, fairly over. But talking about the software, it is sparse.
Yep.
It was nice to have the show end with an amazing Zelda commercial, or trailer, rather, and have that be a launch game. They needed that for sure. They started off with 1-2 Switch, which is officially the worst named video game in the history of the world.
I don't know about that, but it's...
There's a game on the original PlayStation called Irritating Stick.
To be fair, I bet
and
that
the
stick...
A-Train. Yeah.
Okay. I bet that stick was pretty irritating.
Maybe.
1-2 Switch doesn't mean anything. I think they're going for the idea of, like, all right, you count 1-2 and go. But it sounds really weird. That is the Switch's kind of Wii Sports or Nintendo Land, obviously.
Yeah, it would be if it came with a system.
It should be packed in. It should be a pack-in.
It should be packed in for sure. But in general, like, I think it looks like it could be fun. It's not. I'm not gonna, be suckered in on that one this time, mainly because I don't have it packed in with the system anyway.
That's a thing that someone buys right before we have a get together for a Super Bowl or a New Year's or whatever.
Yeah. I could see that, yeah.
That's when that game works.
I could see that. Oh, one of the pieces of hardware news that we didn't talk about is the fact that you can locally sync 8 of these together, which I think is, like, really cool.
But, you know, you could do 9 with the PS3. Nobody ever fucking did it.
I mean, no games took advantage of it. I would assume that Nintendo most likely will. But even things like...
If it's a piece of, like, a selling point, you would think that the console would use it at some point.
Like, I would think, that, like, getting a group of people together to play some, like, local Splatoon 2, which is one of the games they did announce, would make sense. Like, you get people together.
Would it, though?
Yeah. I mean, why not? We used to, like, how many times did people get together before? I get that this was before the internet, but, like, some of people's most fond game memories in general were playing GoldenEye together or playing Halo at LAN parties. I'm just saying, like, it.
And name Chuck.
That's fair. But it's still a point where like, I could see it being done. Like, if we go, like, if we ever start going to midnight movies again and, like, there's that long wait time, getting a couple Switches together because we all have them.
You're right. I'm not saying there aren't situations. I just don't think it, again, it doesn't seem like a selling point to me. It seems like a one-off random thing you might take advantage of once or twice a year.
There's
not like a thing you're going to use on the weekly or you know, even monthly.
It just
conversely, though, conversely, though, there's a Sega CD game called Wild Woody.
Yeah, Wild Woody. Is that got Gandhi in it?
You really just took time out to look up the worst video game names of all time?
Yeah. That was one of them.
All right.
Another one's Princess Tomato and the Salad Kingdom.
That sounds awesome.
And awful, though, because tomatoes are gross.
That's fair.
I love tomatoes. Ugh. I'd eat one like a fucking apple right now.
God, I saw a video online today of somebody making a BLT in which they used tomatoes as bread, and it made me sick, like physically ill and angry. What else was announced?
Spanky's Quest.
So Mario Kart 8 Deluxe was announced with a...
That's not a launch title, though, is it?
No, it is in summer. Or, no, April, I think.
What are the actual launch titles?
The launch titles
they showed
are...
a bunch of fucking games, but they didn't, like...
So the launch titles are Zelda Breath of the Wild, Super Bomberman R... 1-2 Switch, I think, and there's like one more that I can't remember.
Wasn't
right
it
now.
Springs or Punch or some
Arms?
Arms is not until spring.
Yeah.
Oh, what?
So Arms,
even
actually,
that shitty game.
Arms actually looks like it could be fun if you're okay with motion control. Anybody who played it actually had a lot of fun with it.
Anybody who played it for 4 seconds and then laid down. Do you like? No one played Wii Boxing for more than a minute without wanting to fucking die.
I mean, Trey got winded from Wii Bowling.
Yeah, man. Like, just watching it is fucking exhausting.
There's a game called Sticky Balls.
Shocker.
No, I haven't seen that one yet. I'll let you know though.
Skylanders Imaginator and Just Dance are the other two. So
a shit lineup right
now. Yeah, the third party games. Those are the launch titles. Splatoon 2 was announced for summer.
That'll be fun.
Mario Kart 8 does have battle mode in it for real this time now, which was like the main complaint that people had about the original game on Wii, or Wii U rather. They announced, which was, in my opinion, probably the best announcement of the entire thing, Super Mario Odyssey. Which
Odyssey
I
looked
think
awesome.
It looks fantastic. Especially,
I think that looks great. Anybody that thinks that's just, was Mario not a real person now? What the fuck? Have you seen comments like that?
No. Yeah.
You of all people, anyway. Get the fuck over it. It's Mario. It's a video game.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense that people would be upset, but yeah. So this is very much in the vein of Mario Sunshine and 64, which I think is great. I will admit that yes, when I first saw the trailer, it didn't look great in terms of graphics. But when you watch the direct feed from the conference,
I thought it looked amazing.
Much smoother and looks much much better. Because I was not impressed with the graphics on it initially, and this is a console that's not going to be as powerful as the quote unquote HD twins. But the concept
of that,
a lot of people do.
Those people suck.
Yes, the concept of that game in general is super cool.
They can put HD twins in their mouth.
It does seem to be. It does seem to be that the real world, or my favorite thing in the entire conference, New Donk City.
Yeah, new donk with a K.
Yes, it's the best.
It's not like you said dong.
Nope, new donk,
which isn't much better, but still.
Anyway, it is the hub world, or so it seems to be, like the Peach's Castle in this particular game. It seems to be, initially I thought you jumped off of buildings into the actual like worlds the way you did. You jumped into paintings.
Right.
But instead, it looks to be that actually that ship that he jumps into seems to be the way you get back and forth. Like, I think you go to the helipads, because at least in that trailer, they showed him jumping into that weird Mario-ass ship and flying off in the distance from the city, and then you saw that is where he came out for the actual world itself.
So you think the ship is the hub world?
No, the city is the hub world, but you go from the city to other worlds
via
the ship.
Yeah.
See, I was kind of picturing the city as one of the worlds, because they were all very, very, very diverse, and that would fall in line with that. So if the ship, like you get in the ship, and then it takes you to whatever, like a Mario Galaxy kind of thing, and then you pick what world you go to, I would not be surprised if that city was one of the worlds.
I wouldn't be surprised. I think that it's not going to be that, just because, like, they kind of went back and forth with it a couple different times as well. So either way, I think that him being in the real world is kind of funny and kind of cool at the same time. Seeing it, like, the platforming and the using the hat for platforming as well and using it as a weapon, I thought was really cool. Like, they do enough to kind of change the way that, or to add to Mario's repertoire to make it a little bit more interesting.
The hat's not going to have eyes, though, is it?
No. Yep. Oh, does it?
Yeah.
It didn't in any of the it did in the logo, but I don't remember seeing it in any of the actual footage.
Yeah, I didn't either.
I guarantee you there will be some kind of cutscene or something. Like, there's no way they made that big of a point of that thing having eyes at the end. It was like this, like, giant stinger on the end of the trailer.
Yeah, and then what's his name had a hat with eyes on it and shit.
I can't see that play. It looks like it's going to be a character in the game.
I'd rather play Tongue of the Fat Man, which came out on PC in 1989.
You gotta stop.
I'm not going to.
Do you, though?
Xenoblade 2 was announced, which I think is awesome, but that is, again, a Rob and Josh Barnett as game.
Yeah, it's a very niche title.
Yeah. They did confirm that FIFA and NBA 2K18 and Skyrim are all coming out on the system.
Skyrim was one where I'm like, I get it, portable Skyrim. Like, there are people that are excited about that, I'm sure. But, like, this idea of, like, getting really fucking stoked that this new system that comes out in 2017 has a 2011 game on it. It's kind of fucking crazy to me.
Not to mention the fact that a cartridge cannot hold all of that shit. It's like an 80 gig install on the remaster.
I mean, I guess it can hold some of it. It may not look as great or something, but I mean, I assume it's at least the whole game. I don't know if it's the DLC and stuff or not.
No, it's the full game. It is not, so it is similar, but not quite the remaster that just came out. It is kind of an in-between. It definitely has the upgraded color palette, the upgraded texture pack, and things like that, but it's not quite as enhanced as the HD remaster that just happened. But either way, the thing that people are getting excited about for that is it's taking advantage of the system's portability. Like, being able to just, like, pick up and go. People are, like, dude, people are still playing that game. I hate that game, but
crazy.
People are fucking still
it's
playing
it. It's crazy
that,
there will be fans that do this, but it seems to me like it is the most hardcore of hardcore that have already bought that game on their Xbox 360 and then on their Xbox One, like, just this past year, and now, like, in March or April or whenever, are going to purchase that game for a third time so that they can beat it again on the go. I mean, I'm not saying there aren't people that will do that. I'm just saying that I don't think that's any sort of, like, big crowd of people who fall into that particular very specific umbrella.
I would be shocked if that game we already talked about the week launch lineup, but from the time that system launches to the time that Skyrim comes out, I would not be surprised if that is a top 5 selling game for that console.
Oh, I think over the first, like,
year and a half,
18 months, it'll be a top five selling game.
I guess there are probably some Nintendo fans who've just never gotten to play Skyrim, which I can see buying it.
There's going
to
be people who aren't Nintendo fans who's going to buy a Switch so they can play Skyrim in their car.
To be fair, they're
that's just the way it is.
They're also putting Minecraft on this thing, so that whenever that comes out, will be the top selling game on the system.
That'll be
every year.
Yeah,
Minecraft
the number
and
one,
and the number complete one collection of story mode as well. They said, is coming out as well.
Yeah, Telltale is going to release everything on this thing going forward.
Oh, absolutely,
which would be super cool. Let me tell you, if I could take this thing on a plane, and yes, I'll have to get some sort of battery solution for it, but if I go on a cross country flight. And I can play.
How much do you get on a plane and go across the country?
Every goddamn day.
My brother and mother, like, my mom and my brother live out of this, like, on the other side of the country.
I'm aware of that, but I also know that I've known you for, like, 4 years.
In recent years, I haven't gone. But when I first moved out here, it was, like, 4 or 5 times in, like, 2 years that I went out there.
And you know why he doesn't go? Because he can't play Mario Kart in the plane.
Exactly. Exactly.
Look, this, I will never visit my family again until Nintendo fixes this shit.
Yeah. Fuck you, 3DS.
Yep, you guys are assholes.
I took up for you.
Gandhi.
I appreciate that.
Yeah, Gandhi.
So
you wrapped that little peanut.
In terms of things that we were maybe expecting to see and didn't want to see, like, I have one big disappointment of what I didn't see. But did you guys have anything that you, like, really wanted to see, software wise or feature in the system, like, in general?
I wanted to see more software, but no specific software that I mean, didn't see that I thought I would.
Almost like every system, though.
Yeah, and Nintendo
I think
has...
they should have waited for the launch, to be honest with you.
Really?
I mean, because if, let's say, Odyssey comes out in October, why not wait 7 months, build it through E3,
yep,
and have two quadruple A titles launch at the same time?
Yeah, I can see that. They have also said, by the way, that in the, quote, coming weeks, there will be more software announced.
But it's not going to be any, like, freaking, you know, amazing game, or they would have put it on that announcement.
God, just think of the sections, like at stores and stuff. There's going to be, what, four games? And
yeah,
I know that
there's
going
little...
to be some, like, EA Sports games and stuff like that, and people will buy those.
Yeah, there'll be, you know, 10, 12 games at launch, and then there'll be a bunch of, like, blank, empty cases, or not blank cases, but empty cases with a bunch of cover art for everything
that's coming out,
and that'll be the little, you know, 2 foot wide section and
yeah,
every GameStop.
But for me, the thing that I wanted to see, which was rumored and surprised that they didn't show it, and actually I do think this could be one of the games that they do show within the next couple weeks, is that rumored third pillar for the Pokemon games.
I would bet you any amount of money you want that they do not, between now and March 3rd, announce Pokemon.
Not as a launch title, but I could totally see them doing it.
I mean, and I don't just, I'm not saying that they'll never announce that game, though I do think it's somewhat unlikely. I don't necessarily think it's impossible, but announcing it between that event and the launch of the system, I will bet you any amount of money that does not happen.
That won't happen. What
I can
may
see that
happen,
being an E3 thing, maybe.
What may happen? Fire Emblem Fates.
They announced actually, the Fire Emblem.
Fire Emblem Musou, yeah.
Yes, but I'm talking about a port of a game that's already come out that would be easily transferable to that.
There's
that
actually
could come out within a month.
A website that showed up like today that says that is leading to Fire Emblem Fates being...
I would not be surprised.
Or
even
like
if
Mario
it was a
Maker,
game.
I can see like those kinds of things.
Why didn't they put fucking Mario Maker on there?
Well, the thing is, right now, I'm pretty sure the issue is you can't... To have it up on the TV,
you have to have it docked.
And if you have it, like, and to create levels and stuff, you would want it up on the TV and the touchscreen to then, like, move things around and fix the levels. I mean, obviously, they've figured something out because of the 3DS in terms of, like, small screen size. But the issue there is it's still it's a 3DS, so it has two screens.
I
think that, because I know people who say the same thing, I don't feel like you need both of those screens going at a time to make a world or to play that game. Like, the ability to build a world in that game is not resting solely on having a touchscreen. It helps. It makes it a quicker experience, but you could totally build a game they could absolutely have a creator mode in that game that is 100% done with a controller.
Could you not, like, make the level when it's in handheld mode,
and then
dock it,
and
then play it on the TV? That's what you would want to do anyway.
Yeah, well, I mean, I think, like, now, like, with the Wii U experience, you have, like, this, you know, you have the level up on a big 60-inch TV, and then you're just making small changes to where, like, stuff is positioned and stuff with the touchscreen. I will say, they did mention very quickly in passing some sort of, like, smart glass style app. Now, that might be a solution to that issue. And, I mean, I haven't played Mario Maker either, I guess, to be completely fair, but everyone that I've talked to, or everyone that I've heard on any kind of, like, podcast or anything that got into that game with, like, you know, any sort of detail, like, claims that the touchscreen, like, the touch experience is kind of vital to editing and, like, creating levels in a way that is efficient or, like, fun or not, doesn't make you want to, you know, fucking kill yourself. So.
Damn.
Indeed.
Touchscreen it is, then.
Hey, I'm just saying. That's what they said. That's their words, not mine.
Yeah, but I would expect there to be some sort of new Nintendo Direct announcement within the next month or so for a little bit more information. They do need to detail the online service a little bit more.
Yeah, they do.
Yep.
They need to detail. There was that really fun parental guidance video, which was really cute and actually had some really cool ideas, for sure, in terms of being able to
set.
Yeah,
it reminded
me
a lot of like how Apple does their parental controls now.
Yeah, that. T-Mobile, full disclosure, I work for them, but we have a family allowance feature that
you
can...
Did you say G-Mobile?
Yes. We got a family allowance feature that allows like a lot of those same kind of restrictions to be placed.
Yeah.
It's a smart way to do it without just like blanket covering, like you can't do this whole
thing. You can't play mature-rated games.
Yeah, being able to set certain limitations and like get a daily tracker sent to you as well. Like it is cool. The video was really cute as well with Bowser and Bowser Jr. But yeah, the online functionality seems to be linked specifically with that that smart glass type app, and then the actual gameplay and voice chat and everything is done through the system itself. I'm intrigued to see maybe they do the voice chat through the app itself, and that helps minimize some of the battery drain for doing something like that. I'm intrigued to see where they go from that. But right now, I am really excited still for it. I do think the presentation was way too Japanese and way too kind of clusterfucked. There were a lot of times where like they brought somebody up to not show or say anything. They had the guy from Sega come up and basically just say, this is a thing that exists and we're thinking about maybe putting a game on here.
Have a good day, bye.
Yeah, he just walked off stage. And then Suda51.
Sega, bitch.
Yeah. Now, Sonic Mania looks awesome.
That is the coolest collector's edition I've ever seen, and that includes fucking Breath of the Wild. That thing is fucking bad.
I do, it's pretty cool. With Sonic standing on the Genesis.
Well, not only that, you touch it and it plays the Sega music, and there's a Sega cartridge of Sonic that slides out, and there's a fucking golden ring inside
of
it.
I didn't even see all
that.
That's
badass, man.
That is really cool. I'm really upset that the Zelda like Sword Edition or whatever is sold out everywhere and that it was not coming to physical stores.
That sword kind of looks cheap, though, dude. I'll go ahead and tell you right now.
I would still love to have it.
Yeah, you would.
Either way, I'm excited to see more of what's coming for sure.
What? I am, too.
I appreciate that.
It's going to be great.
All right. We're going to wrap it up on that because I don't know what the fuck
is going
on.
Yeah, we're going to wrap it up.
All right. Thank you guys so much for listening and watching on Facebook Live. And I'm so sorry for everything that has happened tonight. But make sure you check out our Geek, in which we actually get into some more predictions this week in terms of what is coming up in 2017 with video games.
That was a very abrupt ending.
I thought somebody was going to say something else. And you guys just like, nobody wants to do anything.
Gandhi 2017. Peace out.